at risk, and how prepared are we?
Are we next in America?
How safe are we in America?
Can we prevent a subway or bus attack in the U.S.?
This is why I thought the Brits should have let the French have the Olympics.
Why are they doing this?
You have to wonder, will we ever truly feel safe again?
There's a lot to worry about in America today. Terrorism, the economy, gay marriage. But when the anxiety sets in, I turn off the TV, pull up a chair, pop a Percocet, and a nice cold Brooklyn lager, and I turn on the Lazlow Show.
Stand by, baby.
Starting right now.
Please, stand by.
Should we start with the national anthem? You know what? Screw it. I got too drunk last night. Just, play the opening music.
Lazlow Show. Episode 6, we shall call this The Return of Wayne. On this episode, we will have Wayne watch a sexual harassment video to atone for his sins from the show that we will call The Albino Show from last week. We've also got some Marines coming to talk on the show. We've got guys that actually repo cars coming in the studio. Frank Chavez, who was a big guy in a certain video game, but now he's repoing cars. This is episode 6 of the Lazlow Show. A couple of people complaining about the music last week, so instead of just having some Led Zeppelin, we'll have some Led Snooplin.
In the crib, ma. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Never get an attitude. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don and I'm all the best cause I got it going on. I'm a nice dude with some nice dreams. See these ice cubes. See these ice creams. Eligible bachelor. $1 million boat. That's whiter than what's spilling down your throat. The phantom exterior like fish eggs. The interior like suicide was red. I can exercise you, this could be your phys ed. Cheat on your man, why that's how you get a his head. Killer with the weed, I know killers in the street. They make you feel like you're chilling in the heat. So don't try to run up on my ear talking all that raspy shit. Trying to ask me shit. When my big investor ain't gonna pass me shit. You should think about it, take a second. Matter of fact, you should take 4B and think before you fuck with little skateboard B.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. The pigs try to get at you. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. But get an attitude. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don and I'm all the best. Cause I got it going on. 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 I'm a gangster, but y'all knew that. The big boss dog, yeah, I had to do that. I keep a blue flag hanging out my backside, but only on the left side. Yeah, that's the crip side. Ain't no other way to play the game the way I play. I cut so much you thought I was a DJ. 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 DJ, 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 DJ. When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. The pigs try to get at you. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Get an attitude. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don and I'm over best cause I got it going on. Drop it like it's hot. 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 I got it going on. Drop it like it's hot.
Oh, man, the crowd's going nuts. 93 K-Rock, it is the Lazlow Show in studio here with Big Wayne.
Alrighty.
And Reed. So we should talk. Well, we'll get to last week's show a little bit, because we're going to make you watch a sexual harassment video, Wayne.
Oh my God.
But Wayne's got some big news. His first appearance was last week, Reed. And he's got some big news. He's coming correct.
What is it? Let loose, man.
I'm picking up a sponsorship.
You are not.
Not only a sponsorship, he's going to be doing live events. He was sorting this all out between last week and this week.
Dude's been
on the radio once.
Yep.
What do you got? Lay it down.
I can say what it is?
I don't know. It's between you and him.
It's going to be like a little surf competition in Long Beach, and I'm going to represent
He's going to be like surf con. There's a surf competition and a bodyboarding competition.
A bodyboarding competition is actually what it is.
And Wayne, I think, might end up being the MC. If he closes the deal, he's got people.
I'm working on a high-end number, though.
How much cash are we talking about here?
Well, you know, Paris Hilton gets paid $9,000 a minute to appear at your party.
That's right.
So
I don't know if I'm quite that high.
Plus, she gives out a little something extra when she shows up.
I'm sure.
That I'm not sure you're willing to
I'm just
do.
Looking for the boys here to be taken care of.
That's not, so something's going to trickle down our way?
You know it.
So I'm excited. So how did this happen? Your phone just rings and
no,
there they
dude,
were?
He looks like a carpenter from Queens with dreadlock beard down to his waist, but he's got mad props.
Yeah?
He knows some dudes.
I got some dudes.
He knows people.
So you get free clothes, you get a free surfboard?
I don't know what we're giving out just yet. No surfboards.
All right,
as the weeks go on, we'll disclose a little bit more.
Wow.
Reed, I finally finished that stupid Lord of the Rings trilogy.
You did?
Oh,
it was
my,
like,
dude,
37 hours in.
I had them TiVo'd the last mm-hmm. one. I made it in like hour intervals. Mm-hmm. I was dying. I was like, whatever, Mordor, Elks, Orfs.
Mm-hmm. And at the very end, the big reveal is the hobbits are gay.
It was just like, you know, I dug it as a movie, but it just takes too long to get through.
You should see, have you seen the extended DVD cut of these things?
What is it, like 18 like, DVDs?
Honestly, they add like an extra 6 hours.
We
for
get
the,
it.
Each
you're,
one.
You're elves.
Right.
The ring wants to kill you.
Well, I'm excited about the sponsorship, but I gotta say, Lazlow, you should be a little ticked off. You got Bupkis, homeboys on the show one time.
He might be in on the limo service too.
He's already. I was in at this like impromptu meeting that occurred on the beach. Within 2 minutes, he was already asking for a limo to and from the show, to and from the event.
That's mm-hmm. right. And then on the one weekend, I'm getting put up for 3 days. How you like that?
But you live there, why?
Oh no, that one's in New Jersey.
Yeah, there's one in New Jersey, and there's supposedly going to be one in Long Beach. And while he was doing that, you were at the U.S. Open, or you were interviewing some guy.
For the U.S. Open.
For the U.S. Yeah. Open. Mm-hmm. Have you ever gone to the U.S. Open, Wayne?
No, I haven't.
You don't belong there.
I've dropped people off there.
To do what?
Yeah.
To attend a tennis match.
What were you doing?
I just dropped them off so they didn't have to find parking. Pick them up 3 hours later.
Oh, dude, it is watching a tennis ball go back and forth.
It only attracts sort of one
and the
type
entire,
of person.
Rich and bored. Mm-hmm. And, like, the entire bottom part is all corporate dorks.
That's it?
Oh.
I know.
It's brutal.
I'm kind of into tennis, too. I mean, as much as you can be into tennis. And you look on the top 10 players in the world, don't recognize one name, hardly.
And a few of them, it's all like consonants.
Right, there's not a vowel among them. It's all like...
He can snort Kalaginsneel.
I don't know who these
who
guys
are. Who is this
are.
Person? Right. Why are the Russians beating us in something else?
But there's some hot chicks in tennis, huh? I can't pronounce the names either,
whatever.
But there's some hot chicks.
Tigress Williams. Oh, sorry, that's a mix of Tiger... Woods and
that's a
Serena
yeah.
Williams. All they care about is those stupid luxury boxes anyway, and $80 wines. Because Reed and I used to work on the U.S. Open account, Wayne.
Oh.
We used to have to write copy for those
that's right.
folks.
Which and the copy was U.S. Open and then the date. Yeah, you know, that took us like 2 months of meetings.
How can we make the font bigger?
Mm-hmm.
So, Wayne, last week... There was some controversy. I was on the phone with Reed for a few days.
Yeah, I think I was a little tough on Victor there.
Because we're trying to figure out the direction of the show, and mm-hmm. we really don't know the direction of the show, but we do know that maybe you were a little abrasive.
A little.
So we're... If you missed the albino... I mean,
I still don't apologize. If it was all done in good fun.
If you missed last week's show, it's posted at lazlow.com. There's segments there. There's also a picture of Wayne with no shirt. But we found a sexual harassment video, because I've actually been told by Infinity/K-Rock that we are going to be forced to watch a sexual harassment video.
Which, I don't quite understand, because that would, you know, sort of suggest that there are actually women who work here.
And the only woman that ever comes in here is Danny.
The only one I ever seen was the Russian cleaning woman in a smock. That's it.
Show
one time, like 2 a.m.
Right, dude, you were grabbing her butt.
Yeah.
And talking.
You were on that, huh?
Yeah.
It was bad. So here, we're going to...
She Asian?
We're going to go through the sexual harassment video, Wayne. You'll be all right?
I'm good.
Okay.
You hear about sexual harassment on TV, and it makes the headlines in newspapers. As an employee, what do you need to know about it? First, sexual harassment is against the law.
You hear that?
And it's against your company's policy. So what is sexual harassment?
Linda, you are doing a fine job here.
Oh, well, thank you, Steve.
But you know, you might try dressing a little sexier at work.
I'm sorry?
I mean, we're talking about your job here.
Now, Wayne, was that appropriate for him to say that? You might need to dress a little sexier at work.
I think it works for him.
You think it works for him?
So we've learned nothing.
Okay.
All right.
And so then we're going to go on to the next bit.
There may be physical harassment.
Wow. You really tense today, Nancy.
Ow, Bill.
Sorry. You looked really tense.
No, I really don't like it when you do that. Can you please stop?
I'll never stop, Nancy. Never.
Now, was that appropriate, Wayne?
That was inappropriate.
No, that was inappropriate.
No means no.
No means no?
No means no.
But what if she needs a little extra suggestions?
Well, that's when you can help her, you know.
With
she's
what?
Shopping at Mandy's, you need to, you know, cure up to another store.
Mandy's? What are you talking about?
You know, like if you want to dress a little more provocative, they got to shop at a better store.
So you're saying that women and the women...
So the first segment, as far as I'm concerned, is okay. So it's the second segment when she says no, you have to agree no.
But if her clothes say otherwise,
you can tell
saying?
Her she needs new clothes.
Okay.
That can be
good
upgraded.
To know.
Here's the next
good
bit.
To know.
In some instances, the harassment may be verbal.
Word around the office is you've got a fat.
Yes, I do.
I've got a fat too. Maybe we should rub our fat together sometime. Maybe a little oil. Two fat together. Oil.
Okay.
But it seems like both parties were interested there. It doesn't seem like there was anything harassing in there at all.
Well, but maybe the one guy, if you see the video, he looks a little concerned.
I don't know. He didn't seem to sound concerned.
So you're saying if somebody comes up and asks you about how well endowed you are, you should just punch him in the face?
No, you can tell him.
All right. Well, here's one with two women.
It might be visual harassment, such as derogatory posters, cartoons, or drawings.
Sexual harassment is not always about sex. It may be the result of a power struggle between a manager and a subordinate.
Man, I could go for a power right now.
Change is slow, and what was acceptable in common behavior years ago can now be sexual harassment.
It smells like in here.
Excuse me?
It smells like fresh in here.
Are you talking about my
maybe.
Everyone wants to be treated fairly and with respect. Treat your coworkers with the courtesy and respect that you want for yourself. It's your company's policy, and it's the law.
All right, so what did you learn, Reed?
Well, it may just go to show how naive I am, but, you know, when you beep out the words, I honestly have no idea what they're even beeping out. I sure could go for a power... beep.
Well,
like
I
lunch
think he meant
or
like
power lunch.
Power lunch.
Power relations.
Power lunch.
Power relations.
That's what they call it nowadays.
I've never heard that. Or it sure smells like beep in here.
I gotta beep it out. It's the new world.
I know.
Order.
I'm just saying. But when you beep it out, I'm so naive.
But
I don't even know what it was supposed to be.
If you did smell, you'd want to know, wouldn't you?
Well, I mean, are we talking about incense? What are we talking
yes,
about?
Yes, we're talking about incense. So, by the way, Wayne was on the show 1 week last week, and we've already got fan art coming in.
Excellent.
He's got fan art. He's got a sponsorship.
I love it.
What is going on here?
We got a cartoonist drawing.
They got the Kid Rock look going.
Caricatures of the guys on the show.
Okay,
Reed,
so
how'd they deal you?
Lazlow looks like Bono from the Octung Baby Tour '92. He's got these big sunglasses on, a cigar, and a hat. Which Wayne is why, that's looks how like, I roll. Wayne looks like the ultimate fighter here with a long dreadlock beard and shoulders that are wide as a
without
city
a
block.
Exactly.
And then there's my ass in the back frowning.
You look creepy.
Yeah.
I gotta tell you, I look creepy.
We'll try to post that on Lazlow.com at some point in the future.
Good work, though.
Somebody told me, Wayne, to ask you about the roses.
The roses. Oh, that was when I was a little kid. I was running down the street.
Romantic moments with Big Wayne.
All right.
I was running down the street with like a group of friends, and sure enough, there was a new florist that opened in the neighborhood, and I didn't exactly know that. And there was some boxes out in front, and kind of ripped them open, and they were long stem roses, and threw them all around, had a little parade, and then eventually the store owner came out and said, "Hey, what's going on there?" And he brought me inside the store. Unfortunately enough, a friend of my father's came along and was a New York City cop. He settled the tab, and I really thought I got over, you know, if you know what I'm saying. But
right.
4 hours later, when I got home, I was over my father's knee.
This is the Lazlow Show. K Rock, it is the Lazlow Show. Last week was Wayne's first appearance, and Reed, I called the big boss man at K Rock on Monday, and he said, "Hey, you know, how's the show going?" And of course, then he goes, "How much music did you actually play?"
Right.
And so
1.5 songs.
1.5 songs.
In 4 hours.
We dropped everything. Mm-hmm. And so I said,
"You should be dropping more."
I said, "You know, I had Wayne on for the whole show," and then there was a pause, and then he goes,
"Could you tell me when he's going to be on the show the whole time?"
Well, I'm not that offensive, am I?
I don't know.
Right.
I don't know. You know, I mean, in the break, you're telling us about like some story where you robbed at a shoe store.
Yeah, well, so you want to hear that one too?
What, in Queens? Where was it?
It was Ridgewood, and there was a little local sneaker market, and me and another friend broke into the place, and I kind of stole every size 10 Nikes and Adidas and Pumas that were available. And
How did you carry them all?
You came out, you know, boxes of 6 and 8 at a time, threw them in your car, and went back.
Wow.
The funny part of the story is the next morning, it's like, you know, 8 of my friends are hanging on the corner. We all got on brand new Nikes, and the cops are going in the sneaker store, you know, investigating why all the sneakers got robbed.
And they didn't notice that all these Queens kids standing outside
with
brand new shoes.
Not really. That was the amazing part, you know? And I had, like, on these big red and black, white Air Jordans.
Dude, we were rolling in here, and there's this chick on the sidewalk with this T-shirt that says, "This is what perfect looks like." Walking by. Wayne starts laughing. Does this chick, like, leaned up against the wall, cracked out? It's like, "This is what perfect looks like." She's got, like, a ton of kids. It's like, "This is what perfect looks like." I'm like, "Perfect looks like she banged out a few kids at 12.
I think 15.
15? I don't know, dude.
Hey, Reed, you know, Lazo's birthday is coming up. We're going to have to do the big birthday show. You know that, right?
How old you turn, Lazo? 30?
When is the birthday, Lazo?
22.
22, yeah. Right. 22. Yeah. Are you going to have clowns and pony rides? What are you going to do?
I don't know what we're doing for the stupid birthday show. I don't even know if there's going to be a show next week.
How about for our birthday show, we do something special and actually get a guest in the studio instead of three jackasses sitting around.
We were supposed to have the Playboy advisor
on. Next week.
I didn't really need that guy, though.
Why? Because you got all the romantic...
I got my own advice.
Oh, okay.
And it seems to be working.
Like?
18 years, same relationship.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know. It's because she's able to deal with the whores.
I keep her medicated, too.
That is Wayne. We got a call here.
Hi, I have a question for you.
Oh, you got a question for Reed? Oh, all right.
Why do you suck?
Oh.
You're ruining the show, Reed.
She says you're ruining the show, Reed.
I thought that was a young boy.
Oh, okay.
Oh, man.
I don't agree with that glass cola.
Why?
I think he's an important part of the show.
Why?
Somebody else has got to be here.
Oh, and so, Wayne, we've got something planned for you. Hijinks.
Hijinks.
We're going to have some hackers on the show coming up in the next couple weeks or so.
Right.
They are sending me... a device that kills all cell phones in the area.
A jammer.
Ooh,
it's a jammer.
I like that.
So here's what I'm thinking. We put you in a wizard costume, like a wizard hat.
Right.
You've got your dreadlock beard down to your waist.
Okay.
Maybe a shirt or maybe a wizard robe and walk around with a big, what do wizards carry?
Magic wand.
A magic wand. Mm-hmm.
I already have my own wand, too.
I'm sure you do. And, go up behind people that are speaking loudly on their mobile phone, hit the jammer in your pocket, and say, "I command thee to shut up."
And that's it.
That's it.
I'm not going to get my ass kicked.
Look at you. You're not going to.
Look at you.
No one is going to
mess
with you.
Doing it to a guy like you, you know?
Right. I'm not messing with you.
I'll be picking and choosing who was shutting off their phones.
Okay. Yeah, that's the street team.
And something tells me it'd be a lot of chicks.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just want to see the look on their face when he comes up with a wizard hat and a cell phone jammer, and they can't make the stupid call. You know who we really need to jam is those Nextel fools.
Ooh.
I hate the Nextel fools.
I could use one of those at work.
What?
A Nextel
jammer. I know, because
jammer.
The people that are supposed to have them, construction people, delivery drivers, are fine. The people like Nextel Tom, who lives on my street, it's a whip sound effect every time that thing goes off. Because it's always the woman. Where are you?
Right across the street. She's right across the street. Huh?
Even when she's right across the street, you know, she's like, I'm standing there trying to have a conversation with him. Oh, here we go. Here she comes. Got the Nextel sound. What are you doing? Dude, just call someone.
Please.
And stop. Great that you look like a Secret Service agent, but you just look stupid. We got to play some commercials.
Hey, man, they're giving out Sierra Mist over at that booth.
923 K-Rock, it is the Lazlow Show. Wayne's exploits of from the 80s are getting a lot of calls here, I got to say, Wayne.
That's pretty good feedback, too, if you ask me.
Well, I mean, you know, you told me stories about robbing train cars in Queens in the 80s.
Yeah.
For Budweiser's.
Wine. And cereal.
Cereal.
Sandals one year.
It's always good to steal sandals.
The cereal was good, too.
What did you do? You got a boxcar full of cereal?
Cases of Apple Jacks. I came home, my mother was like, where are you going to eat all this? I was like, put it in the closet.
And then there's people calling in, like, you know, recognizing you.
Yo, did you take the sneakers from Sneaker Market on Fresh Pond Road?
Who we got here?
Who is this?
This is Scott.
Scott who?
Scott who? Wayne who?
You're asking us the questions. You called. What do you want?
From Fresh Pond Road?
I can't admit to that.
What?
I can't admit to that.
Why, was that your...
Did I sell you a pair?
Was that your sneaker store?
No, he said a little sneaker market. It is in Ridgewood, and it is on Fresh Pond Road.
So all right.
This is like...
So you're batting like 90% right now. You're close.
So, but was that... That was back in the 80s. Was that the store?
He knew the store. Yes, he did.
Wow.
Good stuff.
What is the statute of limitations
I think it's over.
All right, good.
It's over. It was really Reed. It wasn't Wayne. It was Reed telling the story.
Yeah, we're not pulling a cabbie.
Actually,
here.
The fourth member of our show from now on is going to be a lawyer, I think. So, I mean...
Oh, my God.
Good stuff.
I only said he was 90% right.
Okay.
What was the other 10%?
Yeah, right.
Change names?
Yeah, exactly. I didn't make the guy go out of business.
What do you mean you didn't make? Yeah, because the guy he was telling
me. All he was missing was size 10s. Okay. I didn't take anything but a size 10.
Hey, those Air Jordans you have, are those the same from the store?
No, those were a retro pair. And I have another patent leather pair.
I've never seen a person with, like, clean air, like the ones that they sell on eBay for hundreds
I could probably
hundreds.
Get $600 of mine, no problem.
What, are they vintage?
Because they're all hot.
They're vintage.
Yeah, they're all vintage.
they're hot, they last. I gotta tell you, you got it backwards.
They're hot.
Yeah, but they're stylish.
Why don't you, dude, the kids in Japan would pay
$600 to $1,000
for that.
Without a doubt. The young kids in my neighborhood all commented on them when I'm wearing them.
Let's see if we can get our special guest for hour two on. Reed, I got an email from a guy who said that he's in the Marines. Are you there, Russ? Hello? Hey, there he is, Russ. So he's in the Marines. He said he was listening to you and I while they were invading Baghdad, Reed, because Reed and I were in a video game a few years ago that's currently in
trouble with the Congress.
Catching a little press.
And we don't have a dog in that fight, so we're staying out. But so I got this email. You know, I get a lot of weird email. Some of it, I can't understand what they're saying because it's, you know, they're typing in like the elite chat speak. Like Haxor or whatever that is. I need like a dictionary for the kids.
I know. That's when we feel old, man.
I know.
Yeah.
But this one was pretty legit that I got from him. And so Russ, you were in Baghdad, and he emails me and says he felt bad because he had pirated our content. He pirated Chatterbox from Grand Theft Auto 3 and put it on a CD. You had it on a CD?
Yeah, well, we had it on a CD, and then I had one of a really piece of junk, one of the original MP3 players. The thing was probably about the size of a Humvee that I carried around, and we downloaded it onto that as well, played it on the little tinny plastic lab tech speakers we bought.
Now, this is inside the Humvee?
Yeah, or the 7 tons or whatever truck we were driving that day.
Okay, and so it's machine gun out the window, listen to Lazlow and Reed for a little bit, machine gun out the window.
That's it, man.
Really?
Yeah, rolling. And that and of course, some classic tunes. You got to have a little AC/DC and stuff in there to keep it interesting.
Now, how did you introduce it? Did you say, hey, guys, I know we're in a war theater here, but here's a little comedy?
Well, a lot of the guys have played the game before. Actually, most of the guys have played the game before. So when I brought it on, and nobody was expecting it, I just throw it on, and all of a sudden, there's Lazlow kicking the chatterbox. We also had all a couple of the other radio stations on the MP3 player as well, so we'd listen to that. They're good tunes too.
And now, was it ever playing? I mean, because I've seen some movies about Vietnam. Was it playing while you were doing? Was it an Apocalypse Now kind of thing?
Well, there were definitely times where you were not allowed to be playing music, anyways. Obviously, just for safety reasons. But it was only inside our truck. It wasn't like Apocalypse Now with the Hueys flying in and us blaring the sound over the speakers, but the guys in the cabs of the trucks, we all heard it when we were driving.
I have to say, I thought that was damn cool. Now, we've got a buddy, my buddy Wayne here and I, we have a friend who's a Marine who's Australian. Did you ever see Australians over there?
I didn't. I've worked with Australians, the Royal Marines, a couple times. So I work with the
No,
British
no, this
Marines
guy's a United States Marine. He's, he's from Australia.
Yeah, he's a United States Marine, but he's like half Australian, or I don't know what his story is. But
what do you call him again? Crocky?
I call him Crocky. We're looking for insurgents. Look at that one over there. He's a teethy one. Let's roll him over and see if he's got an IUD on him. Is it IUD?
IED.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm sorry. I think an IUD is what you put in a woman's arm so she don't make babies.
It goes in the arm?
I don't know.
I don't know where it goes either. I never used one.
So, in the press, there's a lot of coverage of the war and all that. And I've got a Marine on the phone. I have some real hard-hitting questions.
Well, I'll try to answer them as honestly as I can.
How much and do the prostitutes wear burkas?
You know what? It's hard to tell who is one and who isn't. They all,
everybody
has
burkas
out there.
So, but was there any, prostitution at all?
Not that I know of, man. We were on the road. We never get out of the trucks unless we absolutely had to.
Yeah, it's a bad scene.
That's it, man. Yeah, remember, you're a computer game junkie. Remember Interstate 76?
Interstate.
Never get out of the car. Same rule, man. You don't get out of the trucks. You floor it. That's it.
And just try to get through there as fast as possible.
Mm-hmm.
So you were not thinking about getting some Iraqi lovin'.
No, none of that. No tea, anything on the side of the road. No, we were trying to do a job.
Yeah, my buddy said that actually when they were in Afghanistan, guys would come up with huge balls of hash for like $5, but you can't have any because you get drug tested.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. They don't play around that stuff, even out there.
Well, yeah.
That sucks. Good, you know it, right?
I wasn't in Afghanistan. I was only in Iraq, so. The only thing they were trying to do is sell you whiskey from the side of the road. That was the big thing out there.
Cool, man. Well, thanks for being on the show.
Yeah, not a problem. Pleasure to be on, man.
We'll talk to you soon.
All right, take care of yourself, and to the other Marine there, Semper Fi. Do or die.
93K Rocket is the Lazlow Show in heart attack mode. Wayne has been in the next room. I guess it's the green room for the actual real show they do here at the station. And there's a bunch of free Red Bulls. And Wayne's never had them before. And he's socked out of his brain on them.
He's floating around here like a hummingbird.
Was Laz looking crazy there for a second, though?
You are, man. You're shaking. You're saying things you're not supposed to.
We're trying to give Wayne Radio 101 during the songs about what you can say and what you can't say.
And believe me, it's tough.
And he's been a carpenter for so long. He's used to saying whatever he wants.
Pretty much it flies.
Wow. It's cool talking to that Marine, though.
Yeah, sorry, Ross. Sorry we had to cut you out there.
No, we didn't cut him off. We told him we...
Yeah, it got a little sloppy. We're going to have him back. I think I'm out of that interview, though.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think I'm done.
As soon as I start talking about hash, you got all excited.
Well, it's,
it's supposed to get all bugged out.
It's unfortunate those guys are there and can't participate.
So the website for the show is lazlow.com. The phone number is 888-923-KROCK. Just like I hate it when they do that. Just give the numbers. You know what I mean?
And give them the number when they're in Manhattan.
Oh, I don't need to do that.
Oh, okay.
Just 888-93-KROCK is the number. And then there's segments from the show and various pictures at lazlow.com. This is our sixth show Big things are coming, Wayne. You got us possibly some sponsorship from Rockstar Games.
That's it.
And who knows?
And we're going big.
And maybe some appearances. And I got paperwork from an agent.
Nice.
So we are going down in flames soon.
You better get me on something serious, though, soon.
We're going to be dancing. We're going to be doing live appearances at the mall and the Quickie Mart.
I love that.
So, Reed, I went to go visit those guys that do the RoboSapien. You know that, like, dancing robot?
Right, yeah.
That has
no function or purpose whatsoever.
Well, that's the thing about the whole robotics industry in the last 2-3 years. You know, I've been covering this for, writing articles for Playboy and doing my nationally syndicated radio feature. I run all over the place, and everybody's got, oh, we got a great new robot.
Right.
And it's always...
It doesn't do anything.
It doesn't do anything.
Me too. I was just talking to this robotics professor a couple weeks ago, and I'm like, well, you know, what's the
what,
biggest...
What, at a glory hole? Where were you? You're yelling through the bottom?
A chat room whose title I will not say.
Robotics professor.
But he's saying, I'm asking him, you know, well, what's the biggest thing going on for you guys in the last 2-3 years? And he's like, oh, man, you know, we got this robot that can do origami. I'm like, yeah, great. We got humans that can do...
Origami is the dumbest thing. Look, I can fold paper to a bird. Great, I've got a gun.
How does it help us? We have people that can do origami. We need robots that can do things that we can't do or don't want to do.
The new RoboSapien is coming out. I talked to this guy about it.
He comes equipped with the ability to hear, to identify humans versus objects. He can lie down, do sit-ups, stand up on his own, roam around the house on his own. And you can give him a ball, and he'll take the ball and throw it.
So it's nice to know that the robot can do sit-ups while your lazy ass is sitting there watching a robot exercise.
Yeah, well, it just sounds like we're about 2 years away from a Emilio Estevez movie at this point.
Which is what?
Maximum Overdrive, where the machines take over, Lazlow. Don't tell me.
The movies blow.
Yeah. This was like 85.
And what's worse about this thing, it's a mouthy robot.
He's loaded with jokes. You'll ask him to fetch me a beer, and he'll answer you, so say, you get your own.
Isn't that nice?
See, right, because they can't make him go get a beer, so they just give him a wise crack. I want a robot that actually goes and gets me a beer. When's that coming?
It's called a woman. It's called a woman. You just ply her with Coke and a charge card. You're done. Mm-hmm. What's even creepier about this is that they've made robots for the robot. This thing comes out like in a week or two. The mm-hmm. RoboSapien V2. You can buy toys, so it's robots playing with robots.
If he's left alone in a room with our Robo Pet and our Robo Raptor, he'll tell them what to do. He'll play with them without anybody around. So
the robot has some robots.
Exactly.
And when people aren't looking, I think he bangs the other robots. I think they have robot relations.
That scares me a lot.
And this is what scares me. I had to ask the guy this question.
When do they rise up and kill us?
Fortunately, never. But they'll help you. They may help somebody or bring them a utensil, but they'll never do any damage.
Bring me a utensil.
Mm-hmm.
We've really hit the George Jetson phase of humanity now. I need a fork. Great. The $1,000 thing on the floor is going to bring it to me.
Right. Well,
I don't know.
It's doing something at least.
And, well, it's better than that Ibo dog.
Yeah, what does that thing do?
Sony sent me one of those,
mm-hmm.
and it was running around my house. Those things are useless.
What does it do?
It does nothing.
How much does that cost?
Like $2,500 for the real top of the line one.
You get a car for that.
I don't get it. This is the Lazlow Show. Little Jane's Addiction. Because we do play some music. 92.3 KROQ, it's Lazlow Show. Dude, I can't even listen to that song without thinking of Beavis and Butthead.
That's all I think. I don't even know who sings the original. All I think about is just Beavis and Butthead.
Wayne, how many?
I don't know, but I think we got to have a new sponsor, Red Bull. How you like that?
He's never had Red Bull before, and he's pounding him because there's a case in the green room across the way.
There's only a couple in the green room.
That also doesn't
case
belong
is going
to him.
Home.
Yeah, right. Just like those shoes
just
out of the
like
back of a
shoes.
Store.
Exactly. Mm. I got good Red Bulls.
And the cereal that you stole out of the rail cars.
That's
any
it.
Other... I mean, let's just get it off your chest. Tell us more about the 80s, because Reed and I were too busy, you know.
Some of it's a blur.
Some of it, we were too busy in school, I think is what Lazlow means.
Well, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think that you're supposed to skip school when you're in... when you're in Queens.
Any other crimes you want to cop to?
I don't know. There's another guy here that might have chased us down at one point one day, without a doubt.
In a little bit, we'll have Frank Chavez on. He's an actor and also
a repo man, and he used to represent the Technophile, my syndicated radio feature.
Yeah.
A few years ago, he used to call radio stations and get nasty with, "You got to run his show. Come on. You got a problem? Huh? What are you doing out there in Idaho anyway? Your cows and your..." It was... He got me on a lot of stations. Well, so.
There's a lot of muscle in this studio right now,
right.
And none of it belongs to Lazlow and me.
Well, it's because of Wayne.
Yeah.
You know, Reed, I was listening to... we had Jim Florentine on.
Yeah.
He was probably the best guest that we've had.
Better than me?
Funny.
Dude, you're not a guest. You're not special, Wayne.
Okay.
We hang out on the beach and get whacked. That doesn't make you a guest.
Okay.
Now, I was at Florentine's website. Check this one out, Reed.
Hello?
Hello, James?
Yeah.
I'm giving you a call from credit counselor.
Hello?
Project controller.
Hello?
Yeah. Hey, dude, you still on the phone?
Yeah.
All right, because I got to call my brother and find out if he had a good new year.
Yeah, I'm still on the phone.
Okay.
Hello?
All right, do you have a few moments? Or?
Yeah, I have a few moments, yeah.
Yo, you still on the phone?
Yeah.
Okay.
Debt consolidation is a program.
You still on, dude?
Yeah.
You on the phone?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was developed to help consumers pay their debt.
You still on the phone, bro?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, if you want, I can give you a call back. No, this is fine, actually. I got to run out to work a little bit, so I'd rather get served with now. It was what? Developed what?
Debt consolidation is a program. Yo, you still on?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Debt consolidation is a program. Right.
Oh, you still on the phone?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Debt consolidation was what?
Is a program. It was developed.
Yeah, you still on the phone, dude? Yeah.
All right. Could you bear with me for a moment?
Dude, there's another minute of that.
I don't understand why those people don't just hang up. These are the telemarketers that are calling Jim Florentine, and he just messes with them to no end. And there's like another 8 minutes of that call, and those people just do not hang up.
I don't understand how you get so low on the rungs of humanity
right.
that you have to call people
right.
about debt consolidation. But that's what half the spam's about. Solve your financial woes the Christian way. I guess it's just storm into another country and steal all their stuff. I mean, I don't know what it is.
What is the Christian way?
You know what it is? It's these. You can't trust spam, Reed.
I
tried, but you know, there's percentages of people that actually pay attention to it. The idiots out there. It's pretty big.
It is a big percentage?
Dude, there are... I got one the other day from a Russian woman. I am Stravanska. I see your site. I want to send picture to you. We talk. I send nice a picture. And I'm like sitting there thinking, wow, I almost like emailed her from your email address.
Oh,
like spoofed
come
it.
On.
But there's these guys that answer that stuff and then wire money.
Right.
To these chicks. And it's not a chick. It's a... I am Stravanska. No. My name is...
Those people deserve to lose their money. That's what I'm talking about.
I know.
There's no... If somebody tells you that you have $1 million waiting for you in a Kenyan account somewhere, you know, don't send them money.
The federal...
I shouldn't have sent them money?
Whatever... Yes, exactly. Or whatever.
That's why,
you send them a case of Red Bull or something.
That's why Wayne got rid of his... got rid of his computer.
How about you steal shoes out of the back of a store in Queens and then you send that to Kenya? How does that sound?
I don't know if that's big money making nowadays.
Well, the shoes are still hot.
Coming up later on the show, we've got... Wayne is going to read the news. That's at the 9 o'clock hour.
That should be fun. And we
that
put read in
good.
Quotes as in R-E-A-D.
Thank you.
No problem.
You were making a couple jokes about Wayne's ability to spell.
Yeah.
I had a couple misspellings. And a couple mispronunciations.
Not a problem.
Mispronunciations is... I have a chalkboard at home, and we've listed all the Wayne
terminology.
We've run out of space on it.
And there's always more.
So, Reed, we should play a Jaguar Skills adventure. Can you explain to the new listeners of the Lazlow Show what this is?
This is like our own superhero guy. We're going back to the 20s, the 30s, when radio serials were all the rage. And each week we're going to present a couple minute long adventure of this guy, who is our British DJ ninja superhero guy.
And we've done 4 episodes. This is episode 2.
Mm-hmm.
There will be more episodes. As soon as we get a check from K-Rock,
because mm-hmm.
they thought they could bring the Lazlow posse in here for nothing.
No, we ain't free.
Ain't happening.
No.
And I ain't taking just Red Bulls.
Monday, our agent will be calling. He will be calling. But this is, we've actually had some cartoonists who emailed us. We're looking for somebody to animate this.
Yeah.
I've had a little word from MTV. Got some hookups at Comedy Central. see if we can get a cartoon going.
Let's do it.
So this is Jaguar Skills Episode 2.
My name is DJ Jaguar Skills. Secret ninja powers are revealed to me when I hold aloft my magic stick.
Jaguar Skills.
With my fly Ebony Honey at my side. And my friends, the mighty Fat Boss crew at my back, I battle evil.
Jaguar Skills, the funkiest ninja in the universe. Jaguar Skills. Tonight, we join our hero, Jaguar Skills, the UK's flyest ninja DJ, deep into a session of Lady Pleasin'.
Uh-uh, don't tell me that was it.
Yo, that's super speed, baby. That's DJ Ninja style. I'm in and out before you even know it.
You got that right, fool.
Look, shut your stupid face before I chop your head off with a sword, yeah?
Damn!
It's the Chuck D alarm.
Damn!
Throw me my magic stick and my ninja knickers.
Shortly after meeting up with his sidekick, Tiger Chen, and the mighty Fat Boss crew.
Jag, yo, it's your evil nemesis, DJ Nuptial, the wackest wedding DJ in all of Britain. Oh man, I hate that fool. Yeah, he and his evil ninja crew, they've taken his club and everyone inside hostage. They're about to unleash some romantic ballads and Hasselhoff and all kinds of shit. Look, it's time to get Grey White on these fools and burn this place down. What about the children? Tiger, we're gonna have to go around the corner and rape all the women and children. Jaguar, what are you talking about? Jaguar, your eyes are red. Have you been smoking hash all day? Totally mashed. I'm massively mashed. Look, do you know how mashed I am? I'm massively mashed. Jag, I'm gonna have to take you back to the hideout. You are bugging out. I think it's time to go back to the hideout and smoke some hash.
Join us next time for another Jaguar Skills adventure.
Jaguar Skills. Jaguar Skills. Five gorgeous young ninja pimps protecting Earth's entire galaxy. Always five. Acting as one. Dedicated. Inseparable. Invincible.
K Rocket is the Lazlow Show. Sidekick Wayne, who is full of several Red Bulls, is already looking to tape things to doors throughout the K-Rock studios shouldn't.
Without a doubt, that's a picture. It should be taped right on the front of someone's door when he comes in tomorrow morning. Let him know we're breathing down his neck.
Gosh, no, we're breathing down nobody's neck, dude.
Right,
we have not been paid to do this show. Right. We've been doing, I'm telling you, nada. I got Reed, who is unemployed. You're a carpenter.
That's right.
So you're sort of employed. And then joining us in studio is Frank Chavez, who is an actor, and he's got another job that we'll talk about that's also about as interesting as some of his acting gigs, where you play a lot of terrorists, don't you?
Yeah, I look like that.
get the microphone closer to you, dude. There you go. But Frank was Fernando in the GTA series, and he's gone on to... He called me and said, dude, you got to watch. What was that show, NYPD? What were you on?
I do a lot of background work, so I'm all over the place.
He goes, dude, I'm a guy in the hospital. I TiVo it, and I'm pausing like in super slow frame mode, and I barely see his face. I'm like, Frank!
Hey, that's what you call it.
You've been, what other stuff?
It's a VCR moment.
Get your paycheck?
You get paid, yeah.
That's all
that matters. What do you do? Do you just hang out at the craft services table and shove food down your face?
Well, it depends. Depends on the show. Some shows, they don't let you get anywhere near the grabs table.
Are you serious?
Oh, yeah.
You're standing around all day? Yeah. Like what shows?
Well, I can't tell you that.
Now, come on.
That's not cool.
What about the stars? Are you allowed to?
I might be working on one of them tomorrow.
So what shows?
They'll really give you, like, here's a piece of bread. Go outside.
What shows have you been on?
Law and Order, Rescue Me, A Third Watch.
Oh, you did Rescue Me?
Yeah.
How was Dennis Leary?
He's pretty hyped up.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, you got to give the guy a lot of credit. He does everything.
That
he writes
show,
the show, he directs the show, he's in the show. I mean,
it's like you last
night. And there's actually real firefighters on that show hanging out. Yeah.
So it's cool.
I heard the, what's the big cop show that they film in New York now?
Law and Order.
Law and Order.
I guess it's Law and Order.
It must be.
There's guys from the terrorism unit now guarding the set. Because they're afraid that terrorists will come steal the cop cars that they use for Law and Order and go, you know, sneak through some barricade or something somewhere in, like, a cop car.
Well, they must be deep undercover.
You didn't see them?
I didn't see any of those guys.
You haven't seen any freaky dudes on the set?
No. Well, you see freaky dudes on the set, but they're working there.
So, Frank... we go way back. We used to work at a radio station on Long Island, and he shook people down to take the Technophile, which is my syndicated technology feature. He would call radio stations all day long. The F word was said a lot. He would scare these people in the Midwest. The Midwest is a scary damn place. And Frank would call up with his New York sort of like Hispanic accent. And give me an example.
You know, you're talking to somebody out there in Boise, Idaho. You know, this is what the children really need. It's really going to put your station on the map.
You know, Justin.
You know, their AQH is 50. You know what I mean? Like, okay.
I've had a program director.
I need you to run 22 minutes of inventory.
We broadcast more cows than we do people. You stay away from those cows, Jed. You know, Justice Sunday was last week where they had this big thing in, like, Tennessee, and they beamed it to, like, hundreds of and thousands of churches. It's basically this big rally about how they want to take over over the Supreme Court. And so I was scooping around on the web. You know, there's that book, like, What's Wrong with Kansas, Reed?
Something like that.
So I found some sermons on the web from this guy, Pastor Fred Phelps. Have you heard of this guy?
I haven't, but already I know that I'm going to love this and be scared of
this.
This
is what's going on in Baptist churches in Kansas.
Call the tune and use the right words to describe the homosexual agenda, the sodomite agenda. Thanks.
By the way, this is from a sermon 2 weeks ago. It's not from the 1960s.
It's Westboro Baptist Church. For at least the last 14 years in Topeka, Kansas, heart of the United States of America, at that time, the world's only superpower. There we are. The only ones telling the truth about the fags.
Why they are so worried? There's no gay people in Kansas. I've driven through there. Why are we so concerned? They're all on Cape Cod, right. Fire Island, San Francisco. They want nothing to do with you in Kansas.
We need to get that guy to New York and get him like a membership at Crunch in Chelsea or something. It's like somebody's horizons need to be expanded. You know what I'm saying?
Guys are grabbing his ass right. In Crunch. You're kind of sick. Get away from me.
We'll just let him live in New York for a week or two and see what he thinks.
And here's the, you know, sometimes you hear about the tolerance toward other religions. Here's the tolerance toward Islam that is being preached in the Midwest.
Talk to me about Muhammad. He had sex with a six-year-old girl. That's documented. And we found that out because we've been hearing from these Muslims trying to justify that jackass and just letting it all hang out. Says, well, he married her when she was six. He married her. Shut up. Shame on you. You say that, I don't want to hear any more out of you. You say that, and I say you and your religion go to hell. Nothing you've got to say would interest me in the least bit. Once you give it that the founder of your goofy religion believed in pedophilia. Of the grossest kind.
What is going on in the Midwest?
See, that's George Bush's his line is always like, they hate us for our freedom. No. You know, they hate us for that guy is what they hate us for, not our freedom. That guy right there.
You know, there's a guy over there going,
I've been on the web and I found this guy who said that Muhammad is a pedophile. We must bomb them.
We need to have him on the show is what needs to happen. No,
that could be a good one. Without a doubt.
Yeah.
Well, he's got that. His website, I think, is like God Hates Fags or something. It's just like, just stop it.
Yeah.
Just stop it. So let's on to jacking cars for a living. So Frank calls me from work occasionally. His job is when people don't pay the lease, you go get the goods. Basically,
yes, he's a repo man.
Yes, sir.
So, what does a normal repo entail?
Well, usually it just taking the guy's car from wherever it is.
I know, but what do you just go bash the window out? Or?
No. You know, it depends on. I got a couple of
good
stories.
He can't damage the car. He's got to return the car in sellable shape.
You're not supposed to damage
the car. Right.
Do people chase you down the street?
Well, it depends. No, like, I got a really good story for you. You got a guy with a BMW, and it was like an M3. So
He's probably leased, you know. That's what always happens.
Oh, yeah. It's real high-priced car. So it's a nice summer night, you know, and he's taking out his BMW girlfriend to the Dairy Queen. So when he gets to the Dairy Queen, we show up right behind the guy sitting in there waiting because we have the key. So we waited for him to get online, waited till he couldn't get...
Waiting for his hot dog and his... what's the thing at Dairy Queen?
Blizzard.
Yeah, well, he got cold. Because by the time he was in online, there was no way for him to get back to the car. So the guy jumps in the car, turns it on, and pulls out and drives away. Leaves him there with his ice cream and his BMW girlfriend.
He's got to be thinking that it's getting stolen, though.
Well, yeah, that's the first thing they do. And they call the cops, like, oh, his car is stolen. The cop says, no, sir, you have other issues.
do you tell the cops you're going to get the car?
Well, yes. Sometimes.
It was a long pause there.
Well, it depends, because, you know, some cops are crazy. You know, like they call the people up and say, hey, they're coming to get you.
That's because they paid them off or something.
Or like, they're like, well, not in my town, you're not. You know, it's like, what are you, wild, you know, this is a Wild Bill? I mean, what are you talking about? You know, this is, you know, I'm allowed to do this, not in my town.
My favorite bit is the Hot Wheels.
Well, I used to do that. No, the best is, they stopped us from repossessing at Christmas time. For obvious reasons.
Why?
Well, because...
Pay your bill, stupid.
Cars were full of Christmas presents that never showed up at the auction. So they repossessed the station wagon. And the station wagon was loaded with Cabbage Patch dolls.
Oh, I love it.
And the reason why we knew there were Cabbage Patch was because the paper was really cheap. When they gave out all the Cabbage Patch dolls to their kids, and they opened them all up at Christmas, they were all black Cabbage Patch dolls. You know, most of these guys...
The repo man took all the Cabbage Patch dolls out of the car that he repossessed.
Yeah, and gave them to his family.
And gave them to his family, and every one of their Cabbage Patch kids was black.
Yeah. So
That's legit.
You know, so they don't let us do that anymore. And Thanksgiving, people lose turkeys.
Let it sit in the back and rot in the impound yard for a week. You know?
So, and then you have the people that get away. You know, like the other day, we were trying to repossess a pickup truck. And it was a woman that was driving it, but apparently...
Did you just go and grab her out, just throw her on the ground?
No, you can't do that. Everybody knows the law now.
Smash her face on the steering wheel and toss her ass
Sometimes
out.
You'd like to do that, because some of these people are, you know, out of control. I mean, they're professionals at it. They know that they know that if their car is repossessed, they have 30 days before it shows up on a credit report, so they run right out and get another car. Yay!
Yeah, Wayne was telling me on the way in Queens, they used to just go money down.
My boys would go no money down, buy the car, and 3 months of no payments, park it on another street.
Some people just take the subway one stop.
And then I can remember even getting as low as then just ripping it apart for the parts and selling them.
If they get there. Now they use them for other things like drug running and stuff like that. Like, if you see a car that's got 30,000 miles in, you know, 6 months, where'd you go?
That's right, Florida. Right. Pick up some.
Why does this Z have so many miles on it?
Nana's
What's
house.
All that powder in the back?
Have you found drugs in the cars you repossess?
Yeah.
That's great.
You always find...
Nice little perk.
You always find, you know, like the sometimes you don't. And then when the guy comes to get his car, the first thing he does is he looks for his dad. Like,
uh-huh. Yeah, are we talking about like a couple $100 stash or like a couple $1,000 worth of stash?
Wayne's buying.
It could run into some serious cash.
Nice find.
What do you do when you find that stuff?
Well, you have to call it in. You can't.
Sure.
So you turn it over.
You can't mess around with that stuff.
Right.
Well, that's kind of weird because sometimes you call me on the phone and you're talking really fast, Brad. This is the Lazlow Show. We'll be back with more of how to get your car impounded or repoed. 923 K-Rocket is the Lazlow Show with sort of co-host guy. We've got to figure the roles out at some point, Reed. Sidekick, I think, is Wayne.
That's a good title.
Producer is Reed, even though he booked nobody. I was supposed to book Chip Rowe, the Playboy advisor, and then I partied a lot last week, actually. Right. Forgot to get in touch with him.
Oops.
And also in studio, Frank Chavez is on the Lazlow Show. I've known him since I worked at WLIR/WDRE out on Long Island. He's now an actor, and like all actors, you got to have a real gig to pay the bills. And so he is a repo man. Now,
you rent, is it cars or is it like cocaine boats?
Well, it's no cocaine boats lately. We do cars mostly now, but we used to get involved with like some of the rent-a-center stuff.
Oh, rent-a-center. Now, these places, if you aren't familiar with them, will give you a TV or a bed or whatever at astronomical rates, I've heard, of interest.
Yeah.
And so for like a $300 bed, they're actually an investigation into the company that I read. For like a $300 bed with the payments and stuff, you end up paying like $1,000 for it or something.
Yeah, something like that.
something like that.
What happens is like these people, they furnish their whole house with this stuff.
With rented,
you know. So when you go there, you got to take everything.
So you're going to
take. You got to take the television. You got to take the.
So it isn't like they just missed the payment on the TV. The whole place went under.
They're not paying for anything. You know what I mean? So when you finally do get in the door,
how do you get in the door?
Well, you got to muscle your way in because they don't want to let you in.
What do you need a crowbar?
So there, no. You just
physical.
People make your TV bang. Yeah.
You said, what do you yell? I mean, cops have to yell something.
We don't yell anything.
Are you like that guy Dog on...
Just open the door.
What is that guy Dog on the...
Dog the Bounty Hunter.
Oh, it's like watching White Trash for 30 minutes.
Yeah, well, no. that's what he is.
But you need those kind of big, muscly guys like you.
Yeah, you need somebody that's going to be a little intimidating, because these people can be intimidating as well. I mean, don't get me wrong. You know, like, you pull the mattress off, and there's a guy underneath the mattress. Like, what are you doing here? He's like, I'm sleeping. You know, and then the woman's
We have many people sleeping in this house.
And the woman's got the VCR. She goes, you ain't getting this freaking VCR. And she flings it out the window at the 14th floor.
Oh, that's hot.
So the window, it explodes when it hits the ground.
What do you do?
Pull the speaker. You're trying to grab whatever you can before they destroy it. You go for the electronic equipment first, because they can put holes in that stuff real quick.
Oh, now so guns get pulled out.
Speakers and all that stuff.
So they just start kicking holes in things.
Oh, they go crazy. Televisions explode. You know?
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's out of control.
Now, how are you sure that they're not going to pull a gun on you?
You're not.
So when you're going, are you carrying something?
No, you're not allowed. You can actually get yourself in more trouble. Because if you don't know what you're doing, they're going to take it away from you and use it on you anyway.
Yeah, it's true.
And I mean, either beat you with it or shoot you.
Yeah, I've been that way with sex toys, and it's bad.
Okay.
But you ever been in a fight? You ever had to throw around?
Yeah, you have to. It doesn't happen as much now because everybody knows the law. So everybody does, you know, they want to sue you first. Mm. So they don't want to do that.
That's what everybody does now. They don't throw fists, they just sue.
It used to be, you know, like, you know, they would definitely, and hit you with whatever they could find.
So when you're repoing somebody's cars, you have any young ladies repoing?
Yeah, we,
See, offer like, oh, I'll give you a little action. Take my car.
Leave my car for one more week.
There was this girl, she was a dancer.
Of course she was.
Right.
So we go to the club where she's dancing. So four of us go in, and one of the guys goes in the car and is waiting in the car for us to come out, because we told him what we were going to do. So we go inside, we give her a couple of dollars, this and that, and then we tell her, hey, by the way, we're repossessing your car. So she jumps over the bar and chases you outside.
And she's topless.
What kind of wheels?
It was a Camaro.
Of course it was.
She's like, no, please, I'll do anything, this and that. Blah, blah, blah. So the main guy's like, yeah, all right, you know, whatever. So one thing led to another.
You're the main guy? Are you the main guy?
We won't go there. When she's finished, the other guy drives away. So she gets all pissed off and calls the cops. So the cops shows up, and he goes, well, ma'am, what was it that you did? Did you expect them not to take the car? Now, the guy was, he was a white guy. His face was red. He was going to explode from the laughter. So she just looked at him and finally just screamed out, F you! And left. And the cop busted out. The tears were streaming out. He goes, you guys are bad.
So wait, somebody actually slept with her?
No, we didn't sleep with her. It was horizontal. You know what I mean? It wasn't no comfortable surroundings. It was just a happy ending. You know what I'm saying?
I love a happy ending.
Who don't? And you think of that moment every night before you fall asleep.
Well, not every night.
Repo man sheet going over your head.
Yeah, but you know, there's the other times when you got the woman that comes to the door with one tooth and she doesn't know anybody.
One tooth?
Yeah, one tooth. Right.
One tooth.
Yeah.
What a shock to somebody.
My brother Billy bought that car in South Carolina.
Sure he did.
Yeah.
And you're like, no, he didn't.
Or you get the people that say, oh, I don't know who you're looking for, but how much does he owe you?
Okay. Yeah, right. This is the Lazlow Show.
We're right now. The latest rage for kids is driving parents and entire neighborhoods crazy.
Lazlow.
Why is the music not working? That's interesting. Did you see that? The music's not working, Wayne.
Yeah, I think
we already broke it. I got to drag.
Maybe it's the music you're playing breaks.
Well, you've made a couple of complaints.
Yeah,
you made a couple of complaints.
There you go.
I got a button.
I like this one too.
Do you?
Yeah.
This one goes out to you, sweetie pie. Thank you. Song trails for like 10 days, Reed.
Yeah, and when did Pearl Jam turn into Wilco?
It's
like alt-country.
This is the Lazlow Show. There's the website's lazlow.com. You can email us from there. After a couple Red Bulls, Wayne has now turned to the Playboy magazine in the studio.
Yeah, this is Jose Canseco's wife here.
And wasn't she making like the talk show rounds?
She was making the talk show rounds and saying how she actually injected Jose many a times.
Wow.
Like a good wife should.
And she said certain things were shrivelly.
That's what I love about roids, is how it makes you big on the outside and everywhere except for where it counts. Those guys, I read this article years ago about roids, how like they get a lot of sexual energy, and they'll just roll around and just go have these like sessions that go for hours, but they can't really do anything. They can't come to completion. They can't do anything. They just bug out. And roids are...
Well, I got to tell you, if you had this and couldn't come to completion, there's a problem.
There's a...
This is smoking.
She's pretty hot. She's pretty hot. Since this has turned into like the criminal show, all we seem to be talking about...
Seems that way.
Crime. So far we've covered robbing a shoe store.
Stealing cereal out of a train.
Stealing cars. Mm-hmm. I saw this story that there was a guy hit by lightning the other day. He was on his motorcycle coming back from Sturgis, the big motorcycle. You ever been to Sturgis?
I've never been to Sturgis, but I know about it. Florida?
No. Sturgis is not in Florida.
Nice try, though. That sounded sort of good, bro.
Yeah. But he was coming back from Sturgis, and there was a bit of a storm, and he was going through Wyoming, and lightning hit him in the base of his skull and exited at his tailbone. Blew him right off the motorcycle.
Is he alive?
He is alive. But he's a cop. He was a detective from the domestic violence unit. So you know every guy that he busted for beating up their old lady is like, yes! Yes!
Karmic justice.
My prayers are answered. I will hit my woman, and God shall smite thee for intervening. Isn't there like a chapter in the Bible that says it's okay?
I think that's, yeah, somewhere right after selling your daughter into slavery.
My favorite chapter.
Ah, Leviticus.
Dude, this week there was a kid walking down the street. I was hanging out in the West End of Long Beach, and this kid says, he's going by, he's probably like 7 or 8. He's got a shirt that says, you can have my sister. And his sister's right behind him. So I pull out my wallet, and I'm like, how much? And he goes, what? And I said, how much for your sister? What? I go, it says on your shirt, you can have my sister. I figure I should at least give you a little money. I go, I got 5 euro. I got Jamaican dollars. I got money. And the kid's got eyes like huge. He's going, yes, money. And then the mom comes over and she intervened. She's like, just come on. And starts yanking him along like, oh, the weird pedophile is trying to give the kid. They said it on his shirt.
How old was this girl? Can I ask that?
His daughter?
Yeah.
Or his
yeah,
sister?
Yeah.
She was forming. She was, she could have been there, dude. She could have been there. I was.
How old was the kid?
I don't know, 6, 7.
And you're offering him money, dude. You definitely look like a pedophile.
I offered the kid. He says you can have my sister. I offered him money for his sister.
Yeah, still. I don't know.
Listen, if he's the pimp, I'm paying the price. Reed and I were looking over last meals of keeping with the show theme of crime, people dying. Frank Chavez over there who ruins people's lives by taking their cars that they can't pay for.
And microwaves.
Yeah. You ever take a microwave?
Yeah, like I said, all that stuff.
That's sad if you can't pay your microwave. It's pretty sad, like $29.
Right, exactly.
There's a, of course, it's on the web, but, you know, Texas just executes people left and right.
Don't care.
Don't
women.
Care. And they, there was a website for years, they listed the last meals of, you know, guys that were going to be executed. Bobby Cook, who was in there on death row for robbery and murder, requested a double meat cheeseburger with jalapenos and trimmings on the side, vanilla malt, french fries, onion rings, ketchup, hot picante sauce, vanilla ice cream, two Cokes, two Dr. Peppers, a fried steak chicken sandwich with cheese, pickles, lettuce, tomatoes, and salad dressing.
That's going to get him another day eating all that.
Yeah, really.
Some of these guys on here actually requested like a tall boy, a Budweiser, and a pack of cigarettes. They won't give it to him.
They don't give it yes?
Nope.
I thought the cigarette was like mandatory.
No. No, dude, it's not a firing line. This is not like 1842.
This is a 1950s Western.
Take them out. And
they don't even let you smoke in jail anymore.
Isn't that ridiculous?
Well, I guess. If you're
well,
in jail.
But of course, we have to pay their health care. That's what people were saying. You know, the guys are in there getting cancer, and then you got to, you know.
They're not getting cancer. They're getting beat up.
They're getting AIDS.
You ever been in one of those?
They're not getting cancer. They're getting the HIV. And here's another one. A guy that robbed an adult video store and killed the clerk. Originally from France, but evidently in Texas, decided to rob an adult video store.
It'll turn you crazy.
They probably have two in Texas because, you know, there's a lot of dry counties there. They don't even have liquor. He requested two 16-ounce ribeyes, 1 pound of turkey breast, sliced thin, 12 strips of bacon, two large hamburgers with mayo, onion, and lettuce, two large baked potatoes with butter, sour cream, cheese, chives, 4 slices of cheese, 1/2 pound of cheddar cheese, a chef's salad with blue cheese dressing, 2 ears of corn, 1 pint of mint chocolate chip ice cream, 4 vanilla Cokes, and a Mr. Pibb.
Yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah. You know, one of the things I noticed by looking through, the one guy just requested Jolly Ranchers, an entire bag. Looking through it, chicken seems to be the big driving force on here. Chicken is listed on many of the people that have been executed in Texas are asking for chicken.
Chicken and french fries. Chicken, french fries is number one, actually.
It's...
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, it's crazy. This guy, though, I don't know. I guess he kidnapped his son or something, which I didn't know you could get sent to the death row for, but he wanted 3 cans of Red Bull.
There you go.
A little tip of the hat to Big Wayne over there, who's so jacked up on Red Bull.
And our new sponsor.
Seeing trails. Yeah, we wish it was our new sponsor.
Dude, the other day I was checking out Howie Mandel's new show. He just goes around with like a video camera in his hat. Mm. He went into like a toy store here in New York asking for a doll that would turn his son gay.
I have a 15-year-old son. And I'm looking for dolls that would be appropriate for him.
Okay.
What we're trying to do, my wife and I, is we are trying to raise him gay. You know, he's not gay now, but I want to give him a doll that would make him gay.
How important is it?
That what?
That you get him a doll.
Well, I don't know if it's important. Well, go ahead.
To make him want to be gay.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say an 8.
8. Can I ask you a personal question?
Go right ahead.
It's very personal.
No, that's okay. I don't mind.
Why?
Because what I've noticed, my wife and I have talked about this in depth, a lot of the gay men are very neat.
Very astute.
Very astute. And
nice positions.
Nice positions. And so that's what we want for our son.
Okay. I hope you didn't mind me asking.
I don't mind.
What I'm saying is that Stute.
That's who?
Stute.
And what is Stute?
Stute is a doll.
Is he gay?
Either way.
Goes both ways.
Mm-hmm.
Are you sure? Are you saying he goes either way?
Mm-hmm.
How do you know?
Well, because we have him with young ladies.
Right.
We have him in his shorts, and you can buy...
So you would put him with another man?
Sure.
The Lazlow Show.
And of course, the obligatory sirens that had to be in like every late 80s, early 90s song.
They're coming to get the band, dude. They're too dangerous.
They're too dangerous. They're too sold out. What's Motley Crue doing right now?
Well,
Tommy Lee. He's showing the kids that education is what it's all about. So
I hear that show sucks.
Yeah, I would never watch that.
Can we just come to an agreement as a community, as a society, that reality TV is retarded, right, and we're just done with it? Every network, every cable channel has a stupid reality TV show.
Right.
Well, you're a big fan of reality TV.
You know I like Survivor and The Idol.
Any man that watches American Idol, that is so...
It's good comedy.
That's sissy.
Come on.
Right, comedy, that's what it is to you.
You want
to
talk about bad shows, how about Being Bobby Brown? Now, there's a seriously bad show, dude.
Today on the show, I'm going to beat that bitch.
Give me back my pipe.
Dude, those two...
But how did he bring her down so low?
She was on top of the world, dude.
The crack. It's the crack, brother.
Mm. It is the crack. I used to work at a pizza...
Crack is whack.
I used to work at a pizza place with a guy that was whacked on crack, and he would actually go deliver pizzas to people and then come back and say, oh, they didn't want it or whatever, and then cancel it, and then he would just keep the money. So then I actually called the people. I'm like, how's that pizza? Oh, it's good. I'm like, oh, that's interesting. Went to him. He was he'd also pick up crack while he was out. You ever worked at a pizza place that delivers? It is a blast, dude. We had a racist guy that worked at Godfather's Pizza, ex-Vietnam vet.
How'd you come up with the name Godfather's Pizza?
It was a big chain in the South. You ever never heard of that?
Me. I come from Corrado's.
Corrado's?
Yep, and the people of Ridgeville will know it.
And we had this guy, he was a racist, and we always sent him to the deliveries in the black neighborhoods just because we thought it was hysterical. And he had his big truck with all his, like, ex-army stuff on it. And these kids were in his truck/van thing stealing the pizzas. And he comes running down from this apartment complex screaming, "You little ends!" at him. And he had a tear gas gun. And he shot through the window of his own truck and tear gassed all these little kids. Came running, screaming out. And he calls me and said, we need five more, you know, all those last five orders. I'm like, what's wrong with them? You know, they're covered in tear gas. Like, what are you doing out there?
It's hardcore.
It is. Dude, Oklahoma is no joke.
You're right. You got to come strapped or do not come at all.
When you go to stores in Oklahoma, they've got signs on whether or not you can be carrying your piece while you're in there. Same thing in Alaska.
The Wild West.
When you go to Alaska, there you're supposed to give your gun to the bartender. I told you that, didn't I?
Yeah,
not just
right.
The ammunition, the gun too.
The gun. And then when you're done drinking, he hands it back to you.
Great.
Mm. So I was doing some investigation into online gaming this week, Reed, and it seems, you know those video games where people sort of live like a second life, whether it's, what's the one with the elves and the Elf Quest? What is that one?
Was it an online game or PlayStation?
Some of the online games.
Like the big ones, like the Doom and the Sims and those things?
Yeah, but like
more the fantasy games?
Yeah, the fantasy games that people are getting into. There's one place called There, which is just like a big online world where you run around as an avatar. There's one called Second Life. And the problem is that spouses of game players are actually paying online game detectives to go in the game and find out if their spouses are playing the game and committing virtual adultery with other players' characters in the game.
Why would anyone even care? That's sad.
It's ridiculous. And now in Halo, which is the big title for the Xbox. Do you play Halo, Frank?
I haven't played it.
It's a fun game.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, it's intense.
There's now a talk radio show that is going on inside the game in the while these online matches are going, and I checked out some video of it this week. It's pretty nuts.
Live from New Mombasa in the unpredictable multiplayer universe. This Spartan Life with your host Damian Lacedamian and his guest Bob Stein and Peggy Awet. And introducing the Solid Gold Elite Dancers.
And by the way, the Solid Gold Elite Dancers are a bunch of players, because all these players get together to do this show. And so some of the players are in uniform jumping up and down and dancing as characters. And so these people are in on it. And there's other people that are just in Halo to play. So they sort of run into some issues of their guests getting shot in the head during the interviews.
Welcome to This Spartan Life. I'm your host, Damien Lacedamian. And over here on my right is Dr. Octobit, spinning the finest in chiptune music.
Always gotta have a DJ.
As this is our first show, I'd like to take a few minutes just to explain what is going on here. This is a talk show, like any other, where we invite interesting guests on to tell us about their work or participate in some of our four skits. But the difference is the environment we're in here. This show is taped live from an online video game. The host, guest, and even the crew are all players. Instead of playing the usual game, though, and shooting at each other, we're using the game to make the show.
And they've got people surrounding them while they're trying to interview people. Just machine gunning folks, trying to keep them from running in and killing the guests. Maybe this is where we should take our show, Reed, into some like cyberspace. What do you think, Wayne?
Yeah.
So they were interviewing this guy. There's like, you can hear all the bullets in the background. They're driving in this Jeep. There's people, like, they'll get out of a car and they'll be talking, and some guy will run up and jack their car and run off.
Well, here we are. Kind of like spring break here. This is fabulous. Except that it gets a little crazy with the other gamers dropping in. You don't ever really know who's going to join the game.
You know, as usual with movies, you know, the sound effects are in some ways more important than the visuals for giving you a sense of place and where you are.
I don't think they know we're with the film crew.
I mean, how do you, like, keep up a conversation? I mean, it's bad enough doing this stupid show, but with Wayne all whacked on Red Bulls and me hitting the dump button.
Only once.
Only once. But, like, trying to do a talk show while you're getting shot at. I think the website is This Spartan Life if you want to check it out if you're a Halo guy. But, you know what I think would be fun is to get a posse together while they're doing that show, get a big gang together and just go mow them all down. Ruin their show. Yen Frank, you repo cars.
Let's do it.
Well, let's go buy some Xboxes.
Transmitter, you're going to say, why didn't I do this sooner? Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers.
92.3K Rock, it is the Lazlow Show. This is our sixth episode, our second being joined by Big Wayne. And, of course, Frank Chavez is in the studio. We haven't even told what your big part was in the games.
In GTA?
Yeah.
Fernando Martinez.
Give me a quick one.
Hello, this is Fernando.
Okay, we've done that.
We're very happy to be here.
That's a deep stretch, huh?
Yeah.
By the way, Wayne was in San Andreas, and he was like a guy in the park doing illegal things. Out
also another stretch. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, one of the things, in order for this to be a legitimate show, Reed, first off, we're going to need real equipment from K-Rock, which we can't. This whole place is broken.
There's nothing we can do about that.
I've been in radio stations in the middle of nowhere America that have better studios than this. So when you hear people complaining about it, they're serious.
You know, there's a suggestion box outside. That's really true.
Right, and when you put it in there, you could see that the flame that shoots out the top because they don't care. They're like, whatever, print the checks.
Yep.
You'll be in trouble in December, though. So to make this a legitimate radio show, we're going to have some news. And Wayne, who is a carpenter from Queens with the dreadlock beard and the THC habit, we just sprung it on him that he is going to be reading the news. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Over there? All right. Well, we got to. Okay. Now I've got your little, ten wins ticker thing going.
I'm Wayne with the news. Security forces arrested 12 members of a minority Tamils, I'm going to say. Sure. I'm not quite sure. Before dawn on Sunday in connection with the assassination on Friday of Sri Lanka's foreign minister, a Tamil lawmaker said only a peace agreement could stop such killings in the country, which many feared and is sliding back to war. A defense ministry spokesman, I can't even say this guy's name, said 11 men and one woman were detained on overnight raids by soldiers and police who have been searching the capital, Colombo, since Prime Minister. Again, got me here on this one.
Okay, let's go to the next story. Hold on, let's see.
I gotta say,
next story.
An outbreak of mosquito.
Hold on, I gotta get. It's a sad story.
In other news,
an outbreak of mosquito-borne Japanese encephalitis has killed at least 79 children in North India state over the past week, with dozens of other children in serious condition, officials said Thursday. Local newspapers reported that the death toll will be much higher, as many casualties have gone unreported.
That's kind of boring,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah, I think so. I got to say, I'm going to skip over these next two, dude.
No,
I brought in my own. Okay, and you know, I was prepared for the Playboy advisor here, you know, and I...
Do you need... I've got other music.
No, I just wanted you to realize that this past week that Playgirl magazine has announced that after reviewing 2,000 readers, that it turns out that hairy, chubby, poor, sexy men are very attractive over the hunks
of
the
hairy,
men.
Wait, hairy... Slow down. Hairy...
Chubby and poor.
And poor.
I kind of qualify in all that.
Okay.
Except for the hair on my head. Find that these women find these men with love handles to be sexier than men with no love handles and no chest hair. So what do you think about that, fellas?
I think you'd maybe need, maybe I should start eating more ho-hos.
And I'll go back to one of your stories. A 19-year-old St. Johns County man who police said dropped his cell phone at the scene of a break-in was arrested Wednesday after he called his own number arranged to have his phone returned. What he didn't expect was to be greeted by the St. Johns County Sheriff's Department. The phone was found inside a car belonging to a woman who was moving a field.
Mowing a field.
Mowing a field. Look, well, you pre-read this.
So let me get this straight. A woman had her car broken into, and the guy left his cell phone.
That's what it says here.
And then called. The guy called his cell phone to get it back.
To retrieve it.
And the cop showed up with it.
Correct.
Read the gay Batman one.
All right. Hold on
get to DC Comics is all upset.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Paintings of a gay fantasy involving comic book heroes Batman and Robin have raised more than just an eyebrow while on display in a New York gallery, especially for DC Comics, which owns the copyrights to these characters. Lawyers for the comic books publishers want to display closed and threatened legal action against Kathleen Cullen Fine Art Galleries, which opened the exhibit in February. The watercolor paintings by Mark Chamberlain show the superheroes in a number of semi-naked, heroic, homophobic? What is that?
No, not a homophobic.
Homoerotic. Poses.
What would be a homophobic pose? Like flipping off a gay parade? What would that be?
I don't know. You lost me there. One dispatched the Cape Crusader and his companion kissing. I always thought they kissed anyway. DC Comics wants me to hand over all unsold work and invoices for the sold work, said the gallery owner, Catherine Cullerin. Well, I think that's it. And I think you got to get me something a little simpler to read in the future.
You, sir, are a credit to journalism.
Yeah, did you?
I don't come with a journalism degree.
Well, see, Reed has a journalism degree.
Yes, I know.
So does Lazlow.
And I have a journalism degree. And what do you have a degree in over there, Frank?
Life.
Stealing life.
Right.
Living the school of hunt. Reed's almost, you got to know, I've seen Frank when he gets riled up. He'll take your car.
He will. Yeah,
he'll beat you senseless. It's worse than when Wayne gets all riled up. So this has been the Lazlow Show, because we are wicked behind because we dropped a lot of the music. I mean, you wanted me to drop a lot of the music.
I want it all dropped.
What are you going to talk about the entire show then?
Well, I'll have things.
You'll.
And Reed's bringing a lot to the program, too.
Yeah.
You bring me a couple more of those comedians.
I will do.
Maybe some comedians of racial... You did all right with Frank.
Well, Frank's a very mellow guy here.
Well, I know, but I was afraid...
He's not a freak.
Oh, that's good.
Frank Chavez, thanks for coming on the show. What's your website?
FCHAVEZNY.tripod.com.
So, Frank Chavez...
NY...
NY.
Dude,
just register. You know, I registered Reed's name, ReedTucker.com. It's now pointing towards some kind of goat site upstate. And I got to register you, Wayne.
Yeah, you might want to do that.
This has been the Lazlow Show. The website's LAZLOW.com. Thanks for listening. Hopefully, we'll be on next week.
Join us for the next edition of the Lazlow Show.
That's just
my ass.
That's all in my mouth. You
must
be out cooking breakfast.